They love me and I love them. Just don't even over there, all the room for work over there. They did the thing, they love me and I love them. We just so thankful, amen, to be back here at Stone Creek Lodge. We're in Justice Way, continuing to be. This song, this new room, that prayer, we're going to get right into the word that God laid on our heart. Amen. We just so thankful people still come. Amen. We just blessed to be here today. Thank you. Amen. For the Spirit of God. Amen. That has allowed us to be here today. We just ask you to pray this. Call somebody, invite somebody. Tell them, go to my page, Mark Townsend. Go on TikTok. Hey, we're going live on TikTok now. We finally got all the friends and me to be able to go to TikTok and go live with our messages, amen. And we're just thankful, amen. God, the Bible said everything that was made to glorify God. Hey, even TikTok was made to glorify God, amen. We're here today, amen. First time live on TikTok, amen. And that's making me nervous. Yeah, makes me nervous. Because I'm not speaking to a big audience here today, but there's a lot. I don't know how many people that's on TikTok, how many people's on Facebook. Amen. But we're going live. Amen. And I believe this gospel, the Bible said if this gospel would be hidden, it'd be hidden from those that are lost. Amen. But we don't want the gospel to be hidden. We want this gospel to be spread, Brother Dwayne. Amen. To a lost and a dying world today. And we're so thankful, amen, to be here in the streets of justice. Amen. We had a great time last night. Had a great time at Briar Creek Tabernacle this morning. Amen. We're just looking to have a good time in the Lord today. And let me say to you today, if you don't know Jesus in a free pardon of sin, today is the day of salvation. You can receive your redemption. You can receive your salvation from the Lord today. You can be born of the Spirit of God and be on your way, amen, to heaven. Amen. But being born again is the first step of the rest of it. Amen. You got to get into God's Word and begin to dig in it, amen, to find the ways that you got to live, the ways you got to talk and walk, amen. But we're so thankful, amen, to be here today. Amen. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Be much in prayer, amen, for revival. Amen. We have discussed it at Briar Creek Tabernacle starting, I think it's on the 26th of May, and going through that whole week over there. They're going to discuss it and pray about it. Briar Creek Tabernacle, be much in prayer, amen, when the weather breaks. we're going to begin to spread out more and just justice. We've already discussed about going to, what's that little town down there?
Christian
down there at the car wash and setting up. I'd like to get back into Man down there somewhere. I want to be sure. I've done been invited to go to Yeager. Amen. So weather breaks, amen, we're going to be out in the streets everywhere preaching this gospel, amen, of Jesus Christ. Amen. The souls will be saved, backsliders redeemed, the sick be healed, the broken will be mended, amen. So be much in prayer for those, amen. Pray for us, amen, as we go to Louisville, Kentucky, Friday night, September the 2nd at 7 o'clock.
February,
thank you. February the 2nd at 7 o'clock at Liberty Tabernacle. Pastor Kim Lane is the pastor there at that church there. I invite all my brothers and sisters from Louisville, amen, from Bishop Lyons, Brother Cuff, Pastor Flemings, and Sister Angela. I invite y'all to come and be with us there at 7 o'clock next Friday night. Amen. Come and help us. Come worship the Lord with us. I guess the revival either starts that night or it's already started this week. So be much in prayer for that. No, if you get a chance, just go any night, amen, of this revival. They got a different speaker every night. Amen. I just enjoy going back to my home church there in Louisville. So be much in prayer for that also, amen. Let's remember all the lost and children, amen, all those that don't know Jesus today, amen, because I'm going to tell you, time is swiftly passing by, and time is running out, amen, for you accept the Lord Jesus Christ. See, the Word of God said that my spirit would not always strive with you. I would withdraw my spirit. Amen. So let me tell you, you can't just say, I want to be saved today. If God's spirit is not drawing you, you can't get saved. Amen. So if God is dealing with your heart, how do I know, amen, that God is dealing with my heart? It's because, amen, to God, that you, as I like to say it, amen, a something different happening in your heart, amen. Your heart is, Brother Joey said, it's running 100 mile an hour, amen. Amen. And what God is doing is dealing with your heart, and God wants you to repent of your sins and ask Him to come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior. Amen. Here comes Brother Chris. Amen. I've got his ports today. Amen. But it said the office is closed. Amen. But Brother, he'll let me preach you this for a few moments. Amen. Let's go. And remember those that are sick and shut in. Amen. Unable to get out. Amen. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we praise you. Thank you for your many blessings. Thank you for your love, your mercy, and your grace, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this opportunity, Lord, to be here at Stone Creek Lodge in Justice, West Virginia, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for those that will be watching by the way of Facebook and those by TikTok, Lord. Father, I thank you, Father God, for the services that we've had throughout this weekend, Lord. And God, I just pray today, Father God, that somebody would have an ear to hear and a heart to receive your word today, Lord. God, we ask, Father, your blessings, Lord, upon the hearers, Lord. Not only the hearers of the word, but the doers of your word today, Lord. God, I ask you, Father God, to prepare the hearts for Louisville, Lord, on the 2nd, Lord. And God, I pray, Father God, my brothers and sisters in Louisville, Lord, will show up with me, Lord, to worship and praise God. I pray, Father God, for our church in Scottsville, Lord, Freedom Hill Church and all my brothers and sisters. I pray, Father God, for Feet the Faith, Lord, to be there tomorrow night, Lord. God, there at the Washington Center. If you need a hot meal tomorrow night, Lord, and see somebody there in Scottsville, surrounding area from 6 to 8 o'clock, Lord, I just pray, Father God, that they'll come and get a meal. There's no strings attached to it. Just walk in, sit down. We'll serve you. We'll give you food. We'll give you something to drink. And sometime around the 8 o'clock hour, whatever's left over, if you need something to take home with you, they'll make a way for you to get it to go home with you. We ask all of these prayers in Jesus' name. And amen. Connie, if you will, give us a song, please. Brother, I buried your porch this afternoon. Amen. Thanks, brother. Ain't it good when brothers dwell together in harmony?
Oh, my Lord, it's a winding road. It's all been from a heavy load. Feel the weight beneath the ground. Thank you. Oh my Lord, I can barely sing. Waiting for you when you left the room. Angels, no one can hear the sound.
Going to be around the 11th, somewhere in that area. I'm not positive, but just schedule 2 weeks from Friday night. We'll be back this past Friday night. Amen. And we're so thankful, amen, to be here today. And amen. Brother and them wasn't here, and he said, don't worry about it. Take all the time you need here on the porch out of the weather. We're so thankful, amen, that he allows us to do this here on his property. And you know, it's a blessing to be able just to be here. Amen. And we're so thankful. Amen. We're going to get right into the Word of God here today. If you will, bow your head for a word of prayer and reading of the Word. Father, we come to you right now in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord. We thank you and we praise you, Father God. Everything that's been done and said today, Lord, to the Spirit of the living God, Lord, Father God, for what last night, Lord, and today's gratitude, Father God. Lord, we ask your blessings and favors, Lord, upon this hour service here today, Lord. Father God, we ask you, Lord, to bless everyone that have an ear to hear and a heart to receive the word, Lord, which is incorruptible, Father God. And I know, Lord, God's word is ever more settled in the heavens, Lord. And I pray, Father God, bless those, Lord, that have an ear to hear, Lord, as we read your word today, Lord. Hide me behind the cross of Calvary that they would not see me or hear me, but only hear what the Spirit would say unto them today, Lord, Father God. And I give you praise for it all in Jesus' name and amen. You got your Bibles, I'm going to be reading out the second chapter of the book of Acts today. Just a few verses here that God had laid up, amen, today. Just a few minutes ago, I thought I was going into the third chapter of Acts, but the Spirit of God just moved upon me, and I backed up a chapter, amen. I'm going to be reading, amen, to God there, amen, starting in about the 31st verse in the second chapter of the book of Acts, amen to God. And he seeing, amen, this, they before spake of the resurrection of Christ, that the souls
which was left in hell, since seeing this before spake of the resurrection of Christ, that his soul was not left in hell, neither his flesh would see corruption. This Jesus whom God raised up, whereof we all are the witnesses, therefore being by the right hand of God exalted, and having received of the Father a promise of the Holy Ghost, and have shewn forth this, which ye now see and hear, for David is not ascended unto the heavens, but he himself, the Lord said unto my Lord, sit on thy right hand until I make thy foe thy footstool. Now therefore let all the house of Israel know and assemble that God has made this same Jesus whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now when they heard these things, they were pricked in their hearts and said unto Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brothers, what shall we do? Then Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ, for the remission of sins. You shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. For the promise is unto you, unto your children, and all that are far off, and even as many as the Lord our God shall call. Shall call. And with many other words did he testify and exhort, and saying, save yourself from this untold generation. And they that gladly received the word were baptized. And that same day they were added unto the church about 3,000 souls. And they continued steadfast in the apostles' doctrine and fellowship, and breaking bread and in prayer. And fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles, and all that believed were gathered together, and they had all things common. And they sold the possessions of good and parted them to all men, and to every man that had need. And they continued daily in one accord in the temple, breaking bread from house to house, eating their meat with gladness and sickness in their heart, praising God, having favor with all the people. And the Lord added unto the church daily as such needed to be there. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you and I praise you, Father God, for the reading of your word this evening. Lord, I pray, Father God, Lord, that this word that went out on the airwaves and TikTok and Facebook today, Lord. Father God, I just ask you, dear God, to use me for a moment of time, Lord. God, hide me behind the cross of Calvary, Lord, and I'll give you all the praise, all the glory, Lord, in advance for your word today, Father God. Amen and amen. Honey, I begin to thank, and Brother DeWayne and others that are listening, they that are away by the Facebook today, and I begin to think about that, amen. God is amen there in that one verse there. He said, amen, said that all the house of Israel go and assemble, amen, that same Jesus you crucified, God, made him both Lord and Christ, amen to God. And I thought about, amen to God, about the multitude there, amen, that was gathered there, DeWayne, amen to God, and Brother D, the Bible said, amen, it was about 3,000 souls added on, amen, to the church that day, amen. You begin to think about that, about 3,000 souls was gathered there, amen, to hear that, amen, to God, when Peter said, let all the house of Israel know and assemble, amen, that same Jesus, amen, to God, that you crucified, God, made him both Lord and Christ, amen, amen, to God, and they looked at him and said, men and brother, what ought we to do? And Peter said unto them, repent and be baptized. Baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sin, and you shall receive the the gift of the Holy Ghost, amen, amen to God, and they all received that word gladly, amen to God, and were baptized that day, and God added 3,000 souls a day to the church, amen, and to the kingdom of God, amen to God, and then they looked at him and said, amen to God, amen to God. Peter said, amen, said, save yourself from this untold generation, amen, but I like what he said, the promises are not unto you, but unto your children, unto your children's children, as many as afar off, amen to God, as the Lord our God shall save, amen. I read in another place, sir, amen to God, where Peter then was preaching, Connie, amen to God, and there was 5,000 souls added unto the church in a day, amen. That's called a revival, amen. The Bible said, they that hunger and thirst, amen, shall be filled, amen. You look, there was 8,000 souls in 2 days, amen, that was added unto the kingdom of God. If we, amen to God, would get out of the comfort zone and begin to go out and tell them, amen, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand, amen, that they would realize how close, amen, that we are to the coming of the Lord, amen to God, amen. It might be 45 degrees and raining, amen, amen, but I believe that they do this, get a knowledge or get an insight of how close we are to the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. I thought about, amen, when Jesus was descending into the heavens, amen to God, they were standing there, amen, gazing up into the heavens, amen, steadfast looking up, amen to God, amen to God, as Jesus was descending up there, he said, go you there and tarry into Jerusalem until you be endued with power from on high, amen to God. There was two men standing there in white apparel, asked them, said, why are you men standing here gazing into the heavens, amen, for that same Jesus that you see going there into the heavens at the clouds received out of your sight, he's coming back in like manner. I believe, amen, that they could get a grip, amen, to realize how close, amen, to when we are the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, to God, there would be nothing stopping them, amen, getting back, amen, getting their lives right with God, being born of the Spirit of God, realizing, amen, that Jesus is coming back, amen, to God. The Bible said it's high time to wake up out of that sleep the old slugger was in, amen. I believe, amen, there's many asleep and slumbered, amen, trying to get in, Brother D, in the last day, amen, amen, to God. But let me tell you, amen, today's the day of salvation. Tomorrow might be too late, amen. Then 3,000 looked at them and said, what must we do, amen? Peter said, repent, amen. What does that mean, amen? That means to repent of your sins, accept the Lord Jesus Christ into your heart and soul, amen. Amen, to know, amen, that you died out to sin, amen, to God, have been born to the Spirit of God. The Bible said, the old man is dead, behold, I create a new man. What's that new man? He's created in the likeness of God, amen. If we realize, amen, just how close that we are to the coming of the Lord, amen. Amen, to God, we be somewhere, amen, to God, crying out that God would save us, and God would save our children, and God would save unto the uttermost parts of the world, amen. If we would just begin to tell the story, amen, how God is coming back after a people that make themselves ready, washed in the blood of the Lamb, and realizing, amen, that today is the day, amen, and tomorrow is not promised for none of us, amen, to God. I thought about, amen, mine and Chris's friend Kelly, amen, to God, somewhere around midnight, amen, the death angel come by his way, amen, having hope for the bar to work here, amen, but it never come his way. It come his way about the midnight hour, amen, and he was no more, amen, to God. I thought about another fellow right here, amen, to God, sometime about 5 o'clock in the morning, and his knees come walking up the road right there, amen, to God. I don't know what he had on his mind or where he was going, amen, but he never made it back to an earthly abode. Death come and took him out. It's time, amen, that we begin to tell him, amen, you're not promised tomorrow. Death can come at any time. The Bible said, amen, to make preparations today for tomorrow. It's not promised for your life if you'll realize, amen, to God, the devil's playing the game. Brother D and a lot of people are listening to the devil, amen, to God, believing, amen, they don't got to live, they don't got to do that, amen. There's other ways into heaven. There's many of them out there, amen, they're telling there's other ways to heaven, but Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father except by me. Unless my Father's Spirit draws them, they can't be saved. We need to realize something. It's time we begin to go tell and warn warned the people, amen, to flee, amen, from the wrath of God, amen. You think, last man, right now you allow the wrath of God to begin to get poured out upon this ungodly nation, ungodly world, amen. The problem, listen, the Bible said they're going to and fro, amen. The devils are going to and fro, seeking whom he may devour. Who's he trying to devour? He's not after the ones that he's got. He's after the ones that are trying to do what God has called them to do. You wonder sometimes, why, God, am I going through the trials, the troubles, the tribulations? Why is the devil after me so hard? Amen. Because you got something on the inside of you, and he wants out of you, amen. He don't want God on the inside of you. He don't want the Spirit of the living God on the inside of you. Amen. Why? Because he knows, amen, you're on business for the King. He knows, amen, to God, that you're out here trying to win the souls over for the kingdom of God. The Bible said, amen, I wish none would perish, but all would come to repentance. Or I'll be saved next Sunday. Honey, I got news for you, not promised next Sunday. Amen. Death could come your way before a dark comes. Amen. Death could come your way in the next second. Amen. Amen. But why you got breath in your life, amen, and breath in your lungs and your heart, it's still a beating, amen. You need to make things right with God right now. You're not promised, amen, to get another opportunity, amen. God said, my spirit ain't always going to strive with you, amen. I'll pull it away and let you believe a lie, damn your own soul to hell, amen. The prophet, them 3,000 right there, they gladly received the word, amen. What they had to do, they was glad, amen, to receive the word of God. They was glad to hear. All they had to do is repent of their sins and ask the Lord Jesus Christ to come into their heart and be their Lord and Savior. They was glad to receive that word. Amen to God. Can I tell you today, amen to God, if them people in hell had another opportunity to be in revival in hell like you ain't never seen, amen. Amen to God, if they had another opportunity like they did when Jesus went into the heart of the earth to preach to those that were in captivity, amen, if they only had that opportunity, I believe there'd be a revival down in hell, amen, and hell would empty out, amen, to God, that they had the opportunity, they had the chance, amen, but they turned a deaf ear to the Son of God, they turned a deaf ear to the Word of God, they believed the lie and damned their own souls to hell, amen, to God, I believe, amen, to God, if they could have one more chance. I thought about that rich man, amen, to God, the Bible said, there was a rich man who fasted consciously every day, amen. Amen to God, he had everything that he wanted. Amen to God, but listen, there was a beggar named Lazarus playing at the gate, amen. I desired the crumbs that fell from the rich man's table. Amen, moreover, the rich man, I believe he drove by him every day, amen. He had everything that he wanted, amen. Amen to God, didn't want for nothing, had people doing everything for him. Amen, but all Lazarus desired was the fruit crumbs that fell from his table, amen. The Bible teaches us, amen, that the rich man died and he lifted his eyes up in hell, amen. Lazarus, amen, died and the angels carried him to Father Abraham's bosom, amen. To God, listen, as this man looked up out of there and he seen Lazarus in the bosom of Abraham, he said, Father Abraham, he knew there was a God, he knew there was something different, amen. Amen. To God, listen, he cried out, Father Abraham, with I, amen, have mercy on me. Will you send Lazarus back to dip his finger in water? Amen to God, to cool my tongue, for in these flames I'm in torment. He said, nay. Amen to God, listen to what he said. He began to beg. He began to plead. Amen. He couldn't get out, but he didn't want his family to come. Amen. Can I tell you something today? I don't want my family to go to hell. That's why I do what God has called me to do. That's why I do. Amen to God, listen. Yeah, it might be a little more comfortable in a church with heat and carpet, padded pews, amen to God, amen to God, but this is why I do what I do, amen, because I don't want nobody to die and go to a devil's hell, amen, amen, because they won't knock the door of a church, amen, amen, because why, amen, there's so much going on in the church world today, and nobody don't want nothing to do with it, amen to God. Can I tell you something today, amen, you don't got to go to
church to be a Christian. You don't got to go to church. Amen. To get saved, you get saved exactly where you're at right now. The Bible said, whosoever will call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ shall be saved, and he that endureth into the end likewise shall be saved. But that rich man, amen, seeing Lazarus there, amen, to God, he said, Father Abraham, will you let Lazarus dip his finger in water and touch my tongue? For in these flames I'm in torment. Amen. Can you imagine how many of them down there, amen, over the time of the ages of time, amen, to God has begged God, amen, to save them, begged God, begged Abraham, amen, had to give them another chance, another opportunity. And Abraham had to tell him the same thing that he told the rich man, nay. Amen. You got Moses and the prophets, let them listen to them. Amen. And whatever died after the prophets of God, amen, to God, they got the preachers, the pastors, the lay members, had to tell them, unless they repent, they're surely going to die in their sins and transgressions.
Yes, amen.
That's exactly what we're doing today. Amen. Warning the people, amen. Amen. To flee from the wrath of God that's coming up on the ungodly. Amen. Amen. Listen, God said, I wish none would perish, but all would come to repentance. I believe, amen, to God, that the word is going out. Repentance, amen. Repentance unto salvation, amen. It don't matter where you've been, what you've done. Amen. God already knows where you've been. God already knows what you're thinking. God already knows, amen, what you've said. It don't matter, amen. What matters, amen, is today's the day of salvation to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. I don't care, amen, if you was like me, amen, maybe you're like me used to be. I used to be an alcoholic. I used to be a womanizer. I used to be a cusser. I used to be a liar. I never was a thief, amen. Amen, to God, but let me tell you, it don't matter what kind of sin that you're in, sin is sin in the eyes of God. It doesn't matter, amen, to God. All you got to do, amen, is repent of your sins and ask the Lord Jesus Christ, amen, to come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior. And the Bible said he was faithful and just to forgive those, amen, that call out upon his name. I thought about that rich man, amen. He's trying to make a deal for his family. Amen. I made a deal over, amen, over 30 years ago, amen, for my family, amen, to God, amen. And I want you to know something right now. The deal I made with God was, God, I repent of my sins, amen. I ask you to come into my heart and be my Lord and Savior. I've got kids that ain't saved, grandkids that ain't saved. Amen to God, but God made me a promise. He said, if you'll humble down and serve me, I'll not only save you, but I'll save your whole household. I know, amen, that's a promise from God. When God makes a promise, it can't be broke, amen. That's why he said, this is a promise unto you, unto your children, unto your children's children, as many as far off as the Lord thy God shall call. There is a promise. Can I tell you, there is a cause for us to be in the highway. That's why I said, go you out into the highways of heaven and compel them to come into the marriage supper of the Lamb, that my house may be full. Then I realize today, amen, to God, that there's people out there, amen, that work with the pastor, work with the life. Amen. Living it up, having a good time. Yeah, I used to be one. Amen. Until the Spirit of God got a hold of me and drove me to an altar of repentance. Hey, let me tell you something. That rich man, he's still in hell today. And the deal he tried to make the second round, he was Father Abraham. When you send Lazarus back to one of my five brothers not to come to this place, for in these flames I'm in torment. Hey, Father Abraham said, nay. Amen. They got Moses and the prophets had to hear. Amen. He said, but Father Abraham, if one cometh from the dead, they will listen. He said, nay. Amen to God. I want you to know that God sent one back from the dead. His name was Jesus Christ, and they're not listening today. Amen. Why? Because these streets are to be full of people, amen, gladly receiving the word of God, amen, receiving what they need. The salvation of God is eternally. Salvation of God is everything you need in your life. It don't matter what it is. Amen. God said, I'm the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I change not. Amen. To God, if they'll repent, ask the Lord to come into their heart. Amen. He's faithful and just to save them today.
Amen.
But God sent one back better than the last. That same Jesus that the religious folks crucified, God rose him from the dead.
That same Jesus that God rose from the dead is still alive.
Amen.
Says he's sitting on the right hand of God making intercession for you and I. The Bible said, when I cannot pray, that God hears my groaning. He's seen my tears. He knows what I need. Though I can utter a word out of my mouth, he knows what I need.
Yes,
and he knows what you need today. And what we need is a sin killing revival. People get right with God, gladly receiving the word of God. But it's so hard than to understand how simple it is. It's easy. It's more easier to serve God than it is to serve the devil. I ain't saying it's going to be a bed of roses. Because once you get saved, John 10:10 said the thief cometh to steal, kill, and destroy.
Yes.
Listen, if Satan ain't after you, he already owns you.
Yes, amen.
Satan ain't after you, he already owns you. And he wants to put a tag on your toe that says you belong to me.
Yes.
But God said you belong to him. Whether you live or whether you live for God, when you die, you still belong to God. But whether you go to heaven or not, it's between you and God.
Yes, amen.
Not between me and you. Some of them will say, put your name on the church book, let us baptize you, and you can go to heaven. That don't work. Some will say you can get saved and live any way you want to live. That don't work. There ain't no scripture that says that. Bible said the way a tree falls, there shall it rise. It falls in corruption, it's going to rise in corruption. It falls in righteousness, it's coming up in righteousness. But we realize something today. The Bible said they gladly received the word. They were glad. I was like the writer said. I was glad when they said, let us go unto the house of the Lord. I was glad when they said that. I was glad. Let us come unto the house of the Lord and lift up holy hands unto God, worship in the name of Jesus Christ, who was slain before the foundation of the world. Amen. To save the lost, to save a soul like me, to save a sinner like me. He died just for me. He is my personal God. And they continuously steadfast in the apostles' doctrine, fellowship, breaking bread, and in prayer. And the fear came upon every soul, and many wonders and signs were done by the apostles. And all that believed, were together and had all things common. I wish the church would get all things common.
Amen.
I wish the body, all the denomination and association would come into agreement to let God be God.
Yes, amen.
Let the word of God be true, yes. And let God be true. Bible said, let every man be a liar and God be true.
Yes.
So if the word of God is true, who gives me the authority to say that I'm right? As long as it's the word of God, it's right. If it ain't the word of God, it's wrong. Amen? But the Bible said the word of God was for reproof. It is for reproof, doctrine, reproof for all long-suffering and doctrine. And it's to be reproved and rebuked by all long-suffering and doctrine. Who are we to say, I'm right? I'm wrong, but that book is right.
Yes,
I'm wrong, but that word is right. I'm wrong, but the man that lives on the inside of me is right.
Yes, amen.
For all of my righteousness is as a filthy rag. Everything that I can do will not get me into heaven. I can't work my way to heaven. I can't buy my way into heaven. I remember a man following Paul and him around. And amen to God. Amen. He wanted to follow him. Amen to God. And all of a sudden, when the power of God came and Paul and him was healing, doing miracles later on in the book of Acts, sir, he looked at him and said, I want to buy this. So you can't buy your way to heaven.
Nope.
Paul looked at him and said, your money perished along with you. What did he say? Will you pray with me that God will forgive me? Yes. Let me tell you something. I'll pray with you that God will forgive you. But you got to pray for yourself to ask God to forgive you, to come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior. I'll pray with you. Listen, you know, when I... So what I want to say, God knows your name. He knows exactly who you're at right now. He knows what you need. What you need today is salvation. What you need right now is Jesus Christ. More than you need the next drink, the next fix, the next party, the next hangout, the next man, the next woman. What you need is Jesus Christ, and He is the picture of it. He'll take all things that was old of you and make them new again. So while you got time to make up your mind, let me invite you to pray tonight. If you're watching by the way of Facebook or TikTok this evening, He knows your name. And you know, He don't really care where you've been, what you've done, what you said. What He cares about is you'll come and repent of your sins and ask Him to come into your heart and be your Lord and Savior. That's what He cares about. That you don't bow out. That's what He cares about. That's why He came to earth and died upon the cross of Calvary. That whosoever calleth upon the name of the Lord shall be saved, and he that endureth until the end likewise shall be. For today is the day of salvation. Tomorrow may be too late. Quickly, you make that so simple. Let me tell you how simple God made that. If I will believe in your heart that Jesus died and God rose Him on the third day, thou shalt be saved. With the heart, man believeth unto salvation, and with the mouth, he confesses that he's been saved. He's accepted Jesus Christ. So while you have an opportunity, why don't you take that chance today? What do you got to lose? What do you really got to lose? Because Satan will be right there. The minute you accept Jesus Christ, he is like John 10 and 10. The thief comes but to steal. He comes to steal what God wants to put in your heart. He comes to steal what God wanted to give you. He comes to destroy you. That's all the devil does. From the beginning of time, he was a deceiver, a liar, a mocker of God. He is everything but God to help you. He will bless you up one side and steal your soul, put a tag on your toe and says, you belong to me. You're on your way to hell. But God wants to put his name upon you by accepting Jesus Christ. But can you do that tonight? Simple thing. Father God, I'm a sinner. I need to be saved. Father God, I want to be saved. I repent of my sins. I ask you to come into my heart and be my Lord and Savior. I believe that you died on the cross and you raised Jesus on the third day. I believe that with all of my heart. And I believe, Lord, that the blood that shed on Calvary, Lord, it was for me, Lord. God, I believe, Lord, that you have come into my heart. You're my Lord and Savior. And I serve you all the days of my life. Don't allow nothing to separate. What shall separate us from the love of God? Shall height nor death, nor principalities, things present or things to come, shall hold or fire or anything separate us from the love of God? Nothing can separate me from the love of God but me.
Yes, amen.
And I will not allow Satan to separate me from the love of God. I got too much to gain to lose. There is a heaven to gain and a hell to shun, my friend. The Bible said to choose you this day who you're going to serve. Who you're going to serve today. Well, my friends won't like me. My friends won't hang around me. I sit out with my friends all the time. I just don't got to live the way they want to live. They respect me and I respect them. Respect is earned, dude. They know how I feel about some things. They know I know if they don't get right with God and live a holy life, they're going to die and go to hell.
know I love them. They know I'm going to tell them the truth. The Bible said if you love you, the thoughts your brother had an eye against you, go recognize who you love. He won't listen to you, take 2 weeks. If he won't listen to you, bring them before the church. So what do you got to lose by accepting Jesus today? You got a heaven to gain and a hell to shine. If you'll just accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior today. I pray that you realize that same Jesus that they crucified, God made him both Lord and Christ, the Savior of the body. He is your Savior, and he's your Lord, and he's your Redeemer. Father, I thank you and I praise you, Lord, for using us just for a short period of time. Thank you for the word that you spoke to us, Lord. Thank you for the word you spoke to us about, Lord. Thank you for my brother, Chris, who allows me to sit up here on the property, Lord. Even though it wasn't here, I got on the porch, and he said, let's have all the time you want. God, I thank you for that today, Lord. Lord, it gives me my freedom, Lord, and forgiveness, Lord, to be here today. God, I thank you for your spirit. I thank you for your anointing. I thank you for breaking the yokes. I thank you for setting me free. I thank you for saving me, Lord. I thank you for delivering me. I thank you for binding up the broken today, Lord. Thank you for all of them. Thank you for my family and friends, Lord, here in Justice, Lord. Thank you, Father God, for my children, Lord, here in the Bride, Lord. God, I thank you, Lord, God, for my children in protection, my children here in West Virginia, Lord. My family here in West Virginia, my church family, my pastor in Kentucky, Lord. I thank you for my pastor, Russell, Lord. God, the man of God, Lord, God that stands behind me, Lord. The man of God, Lord, that pushes me and ushers me on, Lord. God, I thank you for him, Father God. Thank you, Lord, for everything you know. God, I thank you for the anointing, the power that's up on his life, Lord. I thank you for my church family and freedom here, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for all of us. Oh, God, I thank you. Oh, God, I thank you for my church family here, Lord. My church family and freedom here, Lord. Oh, my brothers and sisters, Lord, I thank you for it, Lord. God, I pray for it, God. God, send them to the highways, Lord, to fail them to come into the marriage supper of the Lamb before it's too late, Lord. I thank you, Father. God, I love you. Oh, God, I thank you. I love you, Lord, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for loving me when I was unlovable, Lord. Thank you for sending your son to die, Lord, when I was in my sins and transgressions, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you found me worthy, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you found me worthy, Lord. Oh, God. Thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. My friend, what have you got to lose but you for this Savior? What do you got to lose for just giving him a chance today? Come into your heart. Thank you, Lord. We'll be back in 2 weeks, Lord's will. We pray for the revival at Briar Creek. Pray for the revival in Louisville this week. Be praying for the other places. As soon as the weather breaks, we're going to be continuing to stay now. We're still making appointments here, but we're going to go to other towns and other communities. And this gospel's got to go out, Dwayne. The Bible said if it be hidden, it's hidden from those that are lost. I got to spread this gospel. It's what God's called me to do. Amen. God's called me to spread this gospel. That all men would repent. That's what God's called me to do. I love you. God bless you.
Mark Townsend, Mark Townsend, here in Justice, West Virginia. good, Savior?
Good.
I see my buddy in the crowd where I told him. Ladies, we love you.